A very, very warm welcome to the two of you, Udayan and Mahesh. It's a lovely afternoon in December in Pune, and I was walking back for lunch. My house and my office, we're very closely located, so I come home for lunch. I was walking back and I said, 3 o'clock on a beautiful winter afternoon in Pune is a great time to catch up with people like Udayan and Mahesh, because we're all relaxed and we're all chilling and everybody's having a good time right now, which is such a relief in a year that's been absolutely challenging. Let's not call it anything else. Let's call it challenging. But it's been that kind of a year, right? Where you've been wondering what's going to happen next, where are we headed? We hit March and we were like, nobody thought we were going to go into lockdown, but we went into lockdown, we came out of lockdown, and all of a sudden the year is over. It's just poof, it's over. Mahesh, of course, will join us. Mahesh has been having a few network connectivity issues. Maybe he'll also join Uday on his screen. But let's start with you, Uday. What kind of a year has it been for you in the real estate industry?
So I guess it is some kind of a roller coaster ride. Being into 8 years in this business, this is something which was a really equalizer for lot many of the players. Nobody knew really how to take things forward in this type of pandemic. This is one of its kind of a situation in last 100 years nobody witnessed. Typically speaking, real estate and small real estate firms, they had lot many challenges, but that's the beauty. The smaller the organization, the flexible that gonna be. So we have found our way out of this situation, and we are seeing that that pause is over, and it's moving at double the pace than it was halted for. So it's the good time is again came back. That's for sure for last 2 months.
Uday, you said some very interesting things. And we do this fairly regularly on the Golganga Pure Delight page. And I meet a lot of people and I have very interesting conversations with them. And every single conversation, I'm delighted to say I learned something new. So you use two very important words. You said equalizer. It's been a great equalizer. The year has been a great equalizer. And the second you said it's moving at double the pace. The market is now moving at double the pace than it had halted at. So I think that's both great news for all the people who are listening to us and who will listen to us even later. You want to tell me a little more about why you're calling it an equalizer, and you want to speak a little more about this whole doubling of the rate and how that has how that feels.
Yeah, sure. See, we are real estate channel partners operating in Pune for last 8 years, and we always knew only real estate since the beginning. So our career is always into this. We have put together 15 years of experience, both me and Mahesh, and being into real estate selling and marketing profile, we are always connected with the ground. We are always connected with the pulse of the market. We interact with customers like daily. We have thousands of leads got processed in a month, and that's why we could understand slightest deviation in the market or the sentiment of the buyer. And we have seen the sudden drop in March when nobody knew what to do.
Correct.
Technology came in. Smaller organizations could really bend themselves into the new systems. Work from home worked really well for smaller organization, where the overhead ridden, the big guys who were always into, the mass and sale of the product had to really step back and pause the operations for some time because overheads and the recovery and entire cash flow has to match in this industry. So there we could manage our entire 6 months from home. Luckily, our team was at their respective places, safe and sound, and that's why it took some time, but we got ourselves back on the track. We were always into a mindset of having a innovative stuff always running through the organization. We started this organization with a digital backbone when nobody knew 8 years back. So we have our own portal called propbuying.com, which generates
Correct.
close to 2,000 leads a month, and that's why that is what saved us in the entire pandemic. And customized CRMs, customized operations of your own systems in place played a crucial role, and that's why we could at least get way out of this situation.
Uday, I'm completely in agreement with you. And in fact, at the Gold Ganga Group, we've always said this. For example, when RERA came in, I remember we used to be sitting together and discussing ki, RERA is coming in, this, that, and the other. And when the documents finally came through, we realized that the organization was already prepared. Gold Ganga was already prepared with all of this. These systems were already in place. So I feel that whenever any kind of market disruptions happen, I think it's only organizations that are prepared, organizations that are proactive, that can survive the uncertainties of these times. And uncertainties are uncertainties, right? Whether it was RERA suddenly coming in, or a pandemic hitting, or GST, or whatever it might have been. All of these things is, I think, businesses have to be uncertainty ready. And I'm very happy that prop buying is one of those organizations. Gold Ganga clearly is another one of those. Mahesh, welcome back. You slipped out of the conversation for a few moments, but you rejoined very quickly. There are some lighting issues at your end, so we're going to see Mahesh in a very dramatic art film lighting. So let us enjoy that. We can't really hear you.
Yeah, is it audible now?
Yeah, you're audible. I think we've spent the one thing we've done since the month of March is asked one another, am I audible? That is one common experience that we
Yeah.
all had. Am I audible now? Is like the go-to question. So Mahesh, you heard what Udayan was saying. Tell us a little more about prop buying. Tell us a little more about your journey inside prop buying.
Correct. Thanks, Reena, for first of all giving us an opportunity to come online and speak to a few fellow members of real estate. Guys, thanks a lot once again, Goel Nagar, for giving us an opportunity. Thanks a lot, Atul sir, and our team. Basically, going back to journey of prop buying, we started this journey 8 years back after having an experience with working a developer for 8 years. Then we thought, let's do something innovative wherein we both of us felt that our potential is not going to utilize with the developers end. So let's come out and do something innovative. And again, after doing engineering, BA, LLB, MBA, we didn't wanted us people to call us as the brokers. So then we thought to get in technology angle into it, and then we thought to come up with a real estate portal. So me, Uday, with few of our colleagues who were good into like technological angle and IT background itself, we developed this portal called propbuying.com, and it's been 8 years now, and we are successfully doing it. So normally, as Uday told, we are generating thousands of lead at prop buying, and now we have almost a staff around 23 people with us, and we work in two fashions. One is like a retail sales for all Cat A developers in Pune. And second is a mandate sales, wherein we are the extended arms of the developers, and our team sets up the size and handle the complete sales right from A to Z for all these developers. So
Correct.
both the experience have been phenomenally good, and we always feel there should be innovation in the real estate broking firm, as we ourselves wanted always to be the developers. But then to start with, we thought let's generate few capital first with this business, and then probably a year down so we can think for the construction part as well. So we always see Atul sir and all whatever mentors we have in industry as our mentors, and definitely in a year or so we'll be starting our own project as well.
Wonderful, Mahesh and Uden. I cannot tell you how exciting it is to listen to this kind of a conversation, because young people dreaming of a future in real estate, and most importantly, all this varied experience and expertise that you bring to the table. You're talking of your BEs, your MBAs, your LLBs. So what brought you to real estate? What happened? I mean, where did that strike you that this is the future for us?
So
These
again, it
questions to both of
was a
you.
coincidence.
Yeah. Yes, Mahesh.
So again, it was a coincidence. After doing MBA, me and Uday both were placed with a reputed real estate company. And believe me, like that was one of the best experience we had and the best exposure we got in the start of our career. So it's always said the best start is a half won battle. So that happened with our careers initially. Spending 8 years with a listed company gave us a very nice start. And in 8 years also, we learned everything which has to be learned in a corporate world. Like we knew
Correct.
everything what has to be done in the service sector. And then there were a few limitations. There was some saturation came into our careers. Like we can we both of us felt that we can definitely do something better, like, but for that matter, we'll have to leave this our share and we'll have to come out in the market, whatever contacts we had, whatever this thing, then we developed our contacts when we started this firm.
So you know, being entrepreneurs, it's a completely different ball game. You thought of technology, you thought of innovation, you thought of all these things. And here we are at the fag end of 2020. Now tell us, you know, while it's very interesting to hear the other side of this entire process of buying and selling, what do you think, what are your experiences with people who want to buy right now? Uday, let's start with you. People who are out there in the market, you're saying that the rate, the pace is double that at which we dropped off. So who are these people? Why are they buying? What are they really looking for?
So we are the few fortunate ones who has seen, you know, always the dullest part of the market. So we are the ones who have joined the real estate after the boom was over. So there are many real estate consultants in industry in Pune who have seen the best of the days, the golden days where everything used to go off stock in a day or two. So we are the ones who have really slogged. We have really have done the sales and marketing as a function in the company with that we have seen, because we have joined in the recession period. So it is not new thing for us. Last year, it back to back three quarters, we have got hit with GST, RERA, and then, you know, different type of reforms in the entire real estate sector, which would never happened in last 65 years of, you know, independence. Yeah. So that was new thing for all of us. And that took buyer a long, long back in his buying cycle. So, you know, the wait and watch situation was always there, and that has no answer. You and me can't push someone to buy a home because it's the biggest decision of his life. And it has too many permutation combination that no science, no robot, no algorithm can fit in. So the one answer which nobody had is why now? That has got answered in this COVID, because people were locked down in their home. The people were struggling to find their space for work from home. The kids were finding difficult to cope up with their school schedules from the entire, you know, small size homes. Old age parents were finding extremely difficult to cope up with the, you know, their daily rituals such as morning walks, evening walks, which are needed for their health conditions. That's why the gated community were most sought after. And the worst hit was the rental, you know, tenants who were staying on rent for a long, long, long time. And they have faced a tremendous hassle in this type of pandemic. And the first thing that they started doing after coming out was to hunt for their own home. And that has changed the entire emotional equation, topping up with the 3% stamp duty slashed by the you know, government of Maharashtra has played the cherry on the you know, entire cake. And that's why people had a now deadline that if I have to buy, I have to buy before certain date. So even though the prices are not increasing for last many years, even though there are taxations getting burdened every year, there was no deadline that why should I buy now, why should I buy, don't buy this year. Now there is a deadline, 31st of December, if you buy, there is a typical saving which is inevitable, and that's why people are taking a shot.
Wonderful, wonderful. So then that is one of the clear things. I think this entire cycle that you took us through, I'm going to come back to that. But Mahesh, what has your experience been? I'm going to comment on what Udayan said a little later. But first, I want to hear what Mahesh has to say. Mahesh, what is the customer experience like right now?
See, Lina, what has happened is initially 10 years back, if you see real estate, that time the product used to get designed earlier, and then we used to find clients for them. So many a times there was a chances that the product was it was a wrong product many a times, and then we used to have to struggle for the clients to choose that product, which was actually a difficult cycle. So in what used to happen in this cycle, the product used to get ready in almost 24 months time, and we used to always struggle to convince clients for that odd layout, for the high pricing, which client was not ready up. Now the situation has absolutely changed. Now developers are very cautious what exactly they have to build, what exactly is the customer's demand. So many times we get the calls from the developers, and we do the service for almost a year. So we study different layouts, we study the customer behavior, what are the market trends, how are the demands exactly. So this complete study goes for almost a year and all. So the product what comes out is absolutely a fantastic product which fits into client's budget and his requirements. So that's the reason if you'll see all the new launches going across all pockets of Pune, you will find all developers are doing it in last quarter, because then the product what they have came up is exactly what is required by the customer. So this was required initially as well. So end of the day, if your product is best, there is no need to sell. So this is what I feel personally. And nowadays, developers are very cautious on these things. So almost all category developers are doing fantastically well. Let it be any poor pocket of the city, they are doing fantastic.
So thank you, Mahesh. I think again, I have a few things to say here, because you know, I hope the people who are listening very carefully. A word that Mahesh just used, he said they're doing fantastically well. Now this is something that we need to understand as buyers, that if a developer is doing fantastically well, it means that people are out there in the market, they're making buying decisions and they're going out there and buying. If they're going out there and buying, it means the homes that we are otherwise looking out for are getting sold out. So as buyers, these are red flags for us. I think what has happened, and correct me if you think I'm wrong, Udayan and Mahesh, for the past few years, because it's been, like we're saying, a recessionary market, or at least a very stable market, buyers got into this waiting habit. Ki are koi nahi, kuch nahi hoga. We don't buy this month, we'll buy next month, it doesn't matter. Ye flat nahi bikne wala, I'll get the flat. Or you'll get another flat. Something will happen. And it became a bad habit, because before we realized it, like Udayan said very correctly, there was no answer for why buy now, and suddenly there was an answer. Suddenly there was a reason to buy right now, and it was a combination of factors. It wasn't just one thing. Like Udayan said again very, very correctly, that suddenly you realize that you have to spend all your time at home. You need a home that caters to your work needs, play needs, education needs, parents needs, all of that. You need a home, and you need it now. You realize that the world has changed forever. And then added to that, what happened was, like Mahesh said, so you know, guys, I kind of get why you're partners. You sort of complete one another's thoughts. So Udayan gave me one part of the answer. Mahesh gave me the other part of the answer. So Udayan said people realize they need to buy the house now. Mahesh said, hey, you know what? Developers realize that they need to plan their products carefully. So they went back to the drawing board and they planned their products carefully. They figured out exactly what the customer wants, and they came into the market at the right time. And now they are doing fantastically well, which means that people are going out there and buying. Now, Udayan used the word deadline. There is a deadline, over, full stop. 31st December, over. Your 3% GST is gone forever on 31st of December. It's not going to happen again. Correct. So now what is your advice, Udayan and Mahesh? Now I'm going to start with Mahesh first, come back to Udayan. So Mahesh, now what is your advice in this scenario? Because like Udayan said, it's a deadline. And deadline is something that I feel that the real estate buyer has not experienced in a very long time.
Correct.
Real estate buyer ko ye urgency experience karne ka mauka hi nahi, kadhi tana vatlas nahi. के आत्ता नहीं घेतलं तर ते संपलं हे मिळणारच नाहीये. सो महेश, आर पीपल अंडरस्टँडिंग दिस? आर दे रियलाइजिंग? समटाइम्स आय फील वी आर नॉट ओपनिंग अवर इयर्स अँड देन सडनली वी वेक अप ऑन द 1st of January अँड से भैया आय डिडंट रियलाइज ओनली की 31st. सो यु नो द रिझन दॅट वी आर डुईंग दीज शोज कन्स्टंटली इज बिकॉज वी वॉन्ट पीपल टू नो. इट इज इम्पॉर्टंट दॅट दिस नॉलेज स्प्रेड्स दॅट देर इज अ व्हेरी रिअल डेडलाईन. So right. Mahesh, do people know this? Are people aware?
Of course, Lina. Coming back to this, I would definitely add it. Before September, when there was no revision in stamp duties, developers were actually on the bottom rates, and there was no scope left with developers where they could further negotiate the prices and give again the further negotiation prices to the clients. So again, second part remains with the government, wherein they realized that if they have to earn the revenue, they'll have to come back on their part. That's the reason we saw the change in stamp duty part. So we were prepared as soon as we got the information. Being a channel partner company, we are always ready to grab the opportunity and the news like that. So we were ready almost 10 days, 15 days prior. We started our pre-sales teams, and all the executives started calling people that this is the opportunity, boss. And if it is a property of over 1 crore rupees, it makes a difference of a They have like 3 lakh rupees as it's a pure saving for a client. So there were many clients who were into pipeline and deal was stuck for a few lakh rupees. This was a really good news from the government, which gave us as an opportunity wherein developer was also not at a loss and customer was also at a profit. So wherever the gap was remaining of 2-3 lakh rupees, which is again a substantial big amount, that this helped us. So we always see this as an opportunity for 6 months. So even right now, whatever calling or our pre-sales team are doing it, we are always seeing that, say, you have an opportunity till March. Let it be whatever savings you have done. It's only a revision of a 1%, which will be growing in January till March. So you still have an opportunity till March to encash it. But then after March, you never, it will be again to a 6%. So there'll be again. So still we have 3 months to get our best numbers on the board. So it's still an opportunity for all of us, for as a developer and for as a channel partners, companies like us.
While I understand it's a great opportunity for developers and channel partner companies, I think I have to put this on the table. I think it's an even greater opportunity for buyers.
Yeah.
Because I am going to make this transaction. I am a buyer. I'm going to make this transaction once, maybe twice, maybe thrice in my entire life. And if this is my first home and I get this opportunity of saving these huge amounts of money, which is 1 lakh, 2 lakhs, 3 lakhs, depending on the value of the home I'm purchasing, I don't think this is an opportunity I should take lightly as a buyer. I really think that we need to, as buyers, we need to assess this correctly. Uday, what do you think? From the buyer point of view, what is this?
So there are a couple of things. Last year there was a chaos in GST transactions because GST was charged at 12% before. Then it was slashed to 5%. Then it is 1% for a couple of category of entire real estate segment. So that was creating one of the ambiguity which was holding people back. Now developer plan their project accordingly so that the GST charged at 5% and 1% bracket. So there's no confusion in terms of input credit and et cetera, which is difficult for a layman to think of, calculate and understand and take a call. Secondly, was this stamp duty registration, which is something which is not in developer's hand. The government is first time taking a slash and a hit, which is once in for all. So I think that is something which is irrevocable. After 31st of March, developer, in spite of his will or wish, may not be able to give any type of relaxation in taxation, which was huge. So ideally, if you see the graph, it was at 20% of property cost, which was a taxation, has come down to 8% of the taxation value. And that has made the entire pocket the lighter for the end user as a buyer. And secondly, as Mahesh rightly said, the right sizing is came into picture. A lot of developers have gone back to their drawing board, created these spaces which were, COVID proof or COVID friendly. You can say when people have really understood the sense of space inside the house, how well they can utilize the entire layout, and they can do the maximum inside a lesser carpet area, which will suit their pocket. So these type of small products, but with a very great efficiency, has came into the market, and that's why people are going for it.
So Uday, again, you make very well. The two of you again put together, you make very valuable points. What you're saying is that there are two things. One is that this is an impetus that is driven by the government. So after the 31st of March, even if all the developers have even the best of intentions, there is no way in which this much savings can be passed on to the client. It's just not going to happen. That is right. Number one. Number two, you're saying that this whole right sizing of homes, efficient homes, the whole designing effort, it's a lot of, not just effort, I think a lot of designing genius has gone into creating the newer products that will be there in the market right now. And I think that when history looks back at this period, it will look at it as a period when the best minds in the business got together and said, how can we continue to ensure that people are able to buy homes? Because I think that is, buying a home is absolutely central, critical to our lives as human beings. And the government got into it, developers got into it, your architects, your engineers, people like you who are advisors, consultants, everybody got in, the best minds in the business got together and said, hey, you know what? We know how to do this. And I think as buyers, we need to we need to appreciate all that effort that has gone in, and we need to understand it's been done for our benefit. The
Absolutely.
whole effort is to ensure that we are able to buy. Now, in spite of that, if we don't buy, what will happen? What will happen in spite of all these great reasons to buy now? If somebody, let us take a hypothetical example of a Rahul Sinha who wants to buy a house, who knows Udayan's and Mahesh's team has reached out to him and said, "Sir, you've been wanting to buy. Ye aise aise ho gaya hai. Stamp ड्यूटी ऐसे ऐसे है, इतने पैसे आपके बचेंगे, आपका राइट साइजिंग राइट प्राइसिंग वाले घर आ रहे हैं." एंड इन स्पाइट ऑफ दैट राहुल सिन्हा सेज, देखेंगे व्हाट विल हैपन. आई एम गोना थ्रो दिस सिनेरियो टू टू ऑफ यू. लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ यू उदयन. व्हाट विल हैपन?
So this is typical scene which we face daily. Urgency and the cost is something which nobody can really have a control, because nobody sells in losses and nobody wants to have a humongous profits. Those days are gone really from the real estate. So the only thing that buyer misses out here is on a good inventory. We never say that entire stock gonna be over. No apartment gonna be available in entire Pune for you or for Mr. Sinha. But then see, we as a channel partner are associated with the project since day one, probably minus days when it is on the drawing board till the last property gets sold out. So we know that the project trajectory is gonna go up. There will always be an inventory coming out in the similar fashion with the similar developer in the same area. But there's a right time to enter into the project. That's a sweet spot for a buyer, because developer transaction goes exactly reverse as buyers. As soon as the launch gets took off, so sustenance you'll have a lot. Hardly few inventory to sell, and when it is ready, of course the leftover stock, the non-vastu stock, or probably the stock which is really not the preferred ones are that is something which came into the market for a premium price, and that is the peakest peak most price that customer has to pay in that entire project's life cycle. So I feel there is always a right time to buy in the entire property. Property never will get finished. There will be always a property for every buyer. But yeah, if it has to be win-win, then there has to be a certain timeline within the project that you have to enter in the project. Otherwise, it will be lopsided deal for a buyer for sure.
Wonderful. I'm going to translate that into consumer and customer language in just a bit. But first, let's go to Mahesh. Mahesh, what do you think will happen? Our friend Mr. Sinha knows all of this, still doesn't buy. Phir kya hoga?
Lina, what I feel is if the client has to buy his first home, there is no other time than today to buy the best of it. Let the price be any of it. Because if you'll see, if it is the first home of the consumer, let the price anything. Now you have this stamp duty and this taxes revision for 6 months. But after it goes, the demand of that person will still remain, because he is staying on the rent of somewhere, because then every 11 months he has to change his address. And that's the reason, let any of the prices be, he has to buy the home. So what we normally do is we always categorize and we always see what exactly the client possesses now. Does he has his first home or it's his investment home? Probably what we feel is normally if it is an investment home, probably we just leave the client and say, "Hey, sir, we can take some time and then we can come back to us." If you like, few of the clients, daily when we talk to clients, many of the clients are always waiting that they should have some flexible payment plans. Like 10-90 is the plan what the developer normally offers. 20-80 is the plan. But at times, if he has liked the project, instead of waiting for that project, we always convince him to buy it now, because then if the scheme doesn't come, he might lose the opportunity. And again, he'll have to wait for the next phase, which probably might take another 4 years for the possession, which probably he might not go for. So priorities of every client are different. Few clients might have ready possession homes, wherein they might lose up the opportunity of the ready homes. Few might say that I'm not in hurry for the possession, but I need a good best rate for that. So we can suggest few of good options for those clients. So there is a client for every property, and there is a property for every client. This is what we feel, and everything gets ruled out. It's only a time matter.
So yeah, I think Mahesh and Uden, again, thank you. But now I'm going to talk about our friend Mr. Sinha again, and I'm going to translate what Uden and Mahesh said for Mr. Sinha. So what they've said is, you know, Uden used the word inventory. Mahesh said inventory. So khair, inventory to is from the seller's point of view.
Correct.
From the buyer's point of view, it's a home. It's a home. It's a dream. It's their favorite place on the planet. It's where all your money, your energy, your efforts, your savings, they're all going into that one place that you buy, one property, small, big, whatever it might be. Now imagine, Mr. Sinha, that you've set your heart upon a certain place. You think this is a good place. But you're still thinking, theek hai, rate aur kam girega, kuch hoga, something this, something that. I will wait to see if I get a promotion. I will wait for this. I will wait for that. That house is not going to wait. And when Uden says that inventory gets sold out, what he's actually meaning is that the house on which you have set your heart will go. And you might find another apartment in that same building. But what Uden said is that inventory is the one which is not preferred by others. Why did that house not get sold? Because nobody wanted it. But because you buy it at the end of the project, you're going to buy a house that is not necessarily something that you would have chosen in the first place.
Right.
And you're going to buy it at a premium. So you'll spend more money. Uden, that's what you said, right? That you'll spend more money.
Yeah. Absolutely.
So that is what's going to happen to our friend Mr. Sinha if he doesn't buy his property right now. And Mahesh, like you're saying also, that this is something that we're all going to have to think about carefully. Ki, what is it? What exactly is it that we're missing out on? Of course, both of you are right. There will always be homes. There'll always be some property or other. It's always going to be there. It's always going to be somewhere around you. But when a person buys a home, that home is bought with a lot of heart.
Emotions.
And you can, and a lot of emotion. And
right.
Now, do you feel that with the clients that you work with? Do you see how much emotion goes into buying a house? And what is that whole conversation like? Mahesh, we'll start with you. What is that whole conversation like? What are the dreams that people are seeing just now?
Yeah, emotions is like, if client values the home, then definitely he won't see the cost. For sure, Lina, that matters. Like, I'll just share one example with you. There was a client with whom we were negotiating for almost a year. And it was a big size home of 6,000 square feet, and costing was almost 12 crore rupees. So it was almost a year we were negotiating with him, and somehow there was always a gap in between. But in this scenario of a COVID, he was unfortunately detected with COVID, and he understood, like, in this three bedroom apartment, if I have my one single life and plenty of money with me, so how does that matter? Like, if I lose my life in this COVID scenario, and that gave him time to think for those 3 months, and he called us. He called us and told us, Mahesh, as soon as the COVID is over, I'll come, I'll be with you. So we set a meeting with him, and after COVID, we sat for 10 minutes and the deal was closed. So he himself could realize the importance of the value of the apartment, which we were trying to make him realize since a year. But then the time came and he came out, and we transacted in almost one single meeting. So this is what exactly client has to realize, that if they really value that home, the deal goes through with no difficulty.
Fantastic. So if you value your home, go ahead and buy it. Don't wait for COVID, Shovid, bhai log. Don't do any such thing. If you value your home, go ahead and buy it. But then what about you? Do you experience these amazing stories of very emotional purchases?
I mean, we are the one who is handling the client, because salesperson in the project, real estate project, generally is on the job. You know, by the time of possession, he may not be there. He might have moved to some other organization. But the person who has bought with us has only one place to go, which is us. So we are the one who have started with his, you know, buying from his research till his day-to-day visits or monthly visits, and then, you know, of course, the further documentation. So we know their case quite clearly, why he want to buy, what is that stopping him. So we try to sell the solution and not the product, honestly. We understand the problem in buying, because home is something which every alternate guy wants to buy real estate for investment or for their own use. But why is very important and what. So we generally try to address why he wants to buy. And of course, real estate is never a rational instrument in the investment. It has always been a emotional, where lot many parameters plays an important part. His parents, his wife, his kid. Nowadays, kids are playing a major role in selling apartment. That's one of the strange thing that has happened. Now, so this is entirely an emotional gamble. And in that, we have to handle with the client, because price is something which is really beyond control. And as a buyer, he will always want to buy it at a lowest price. And if he wants to sell, he has to sell it at the highest price in the market next day. So as a buyer, he changes his position when he becomes seller. So we know his critical parameters when he is making his buying decision. And we try to give a solution beyond the limits.
So Uday and Mahesh, both of you, again, you're making valuable points, and I want to paraphrase that for our listeners today. What they're saying is that, again, Uday, you're a quarter minute guy, by the way. Real estate is not a rational decision. Real estate is a very highly emotionally charged decision. I think we should all make notes when these guys speak. It's very interesting. So you're right. You're absolutely right. People want to buy homes for a plethora of reasons. And again, you're right. Nowadays, children are being key influencers in making these decisions. But that's it. I mean, that's exactly how it is. You want to buy a home, you have to go out there and do it. Eventually, this little window is going to shut. Eventually, you're going to have to go and buy whatever inventory, like these guys say, whatever inventory is available, whatever home is available, you're going to have to go out there and buy it, because your need is not going to disappear. This window will shut, your need will remain. So the wise thing to do is to address your need when you have the best possible window of making a wise real estate decision. Now, all the people that I speak to, there are certain commonalities. One of the things is that people always want to buy it at the lowest possible price, which is right. You put me as a buyer today, I will also want to buy at lowest possible price. The trick really is understanding when the market is at lowest possible price. And Udayan and Mahesh, both of you, I'm asking you this question. Mahesh, we'll start with you. Are we today at lowest possible price?
Of course, yes. Veena, to be...
of course, so, yes.
Yes, of course,
okay,
yes.
Okay, guys, please listen. He said, of course, yes. He didn't just say yes. He said, of course, yes. All right, Mahesh.
Yeah, of course. And both CREDAI as a body and government, this thing, both are trying to minimize this gap, wherein they want to encourage people to come out, do their real estate investments. Because then, Leena, just to tell you, like, we are involved into land transactions as well. So we exactly know where you say the prices has to come down. The otherwise, if you see last month, the steel and cement have gone by 10%, but then the rates haven't. So if you see,
steel and cement is increased by 10%.
Increased by 10%. The steel is increased by 10%. So whatever, like, when we are involved into these land transactions, the land deals don't happen even if there is a difference of almost 0.5% in the revenue sharing or like JV percentages. So if 0.5% matters such a lot in JV deals or in new listing, and the other end where we don't have any controls on the raw materials, how can you randomly say that the prices has to go down and clients are coming and they are asking for the now there was a new statement in last 6 months that what is the COVID discount? So what is the COVID discount for real estate? So that hasn't to be there in that fashion. Like, wherein if your land prices are not going down, raw material doesn't have any control on it, how the developers are going to sell in the losses? They won't. So this is absolutely the bottom prices, what I feel. Whatever benefit you're getting in the taxation, that is the those are the best benefits which clients have to get for another 3 months' time. They should really be serious about their investments. Because then this 3% or 4%, whatever benefit they're getting, this end of the month are going to add into their profit margins when the again taxes will go on back to the 6% or 7%, whatever. So I feel the rates are at the bottom level. This is the right time to buy the property.
Mahesh has said, I asked Mahesh, Mahesh, do you think rates are lowest possible? He said, of course, yes. Uday, do you think rates are lowest possible that they can be?
So I feel, you know, the best time to buy real estate is when you have money in your pocket. So no matter if it is for, you know, the lowest price, and if you don't have a loan eligibility today, you can't buy. So I feel instead of lowest or, you know, the cheapest or the best in the entire locality, I feel it has to be a fair price. At the end of the day, it's not a machine made product. Trust me, it takes a lot of, you know, 32 types of different agencies to coordinate. And that's how the one home gets built. So I feel you should pay the fair price and you should get the best of the quality and best of the product for yourself. You, as you rightly said, it may be the only home in your generation that you will buy. Probably it might be the second home that you're buying than the previous one, and it has to be an upgraded one. So I'm sure, I'm assuming that people will be investing where they want to stay. So I feel developer has to, the regulations are such that the obnoxious margins have cut to a razor thin margin. No developer is making humongous profits today, considering the land prices and, as Mahesh said, raw material spike up. But then I feel if we pay right price, then only we'll get the good quality home. Otherwise, there will definitely be a corner cutting in the quality, which, the deliveries of the product which we are getting. So I feel the price has to be really fair. It can't be out of the market. But the product is something which is more important. The value of the product is important than the price of the product.
Fantastic. So, guys, this is why I say this. I say this again in our conversation. These guys make a fantastic team. So I got both sides to my quest. I got both sides of the answer to my question. Mahesh is very sure that this is the best possible price. Udayan says, you know what? Best possible price to hai hi. But don't stay stuck on the best possible price. Look at the fact that you're getting the best possible product and be happy to pay for that product. And I think this is, again, a very valuable input to the buyers. Because
I'm sure people forget their price, whether you have bought it at 40.5 lakh rupees or 45 lakh rupees. Over the years of 10 years of time, people forget the price, but they remember the quality of the product and the service that they got from the developer. So I think you have to at least weigh that against the price.
Fantastic. Again, fantastic. I'm super impressed with this insight that we forget the price. That I was thinking, I'm sitting inside my home and having this conversation, and you're absolutely right. I haven't thought of the price of the home in I don't know how long, but every single day I bless the home for all that it gives me. So you're absolutely right. And you've just given me a blinding moment of consumer-customer insight that we don't consider the price of the home after we've lived in it, but the value we consider every single day, every single moment that you spend inside your house. It's all about the value of the life that you, your family, your loved ones experience inside that space. So on that note, I'm going to thank the two of you, but not before. First, I recap what they said. And second, I'm going to ask them to give you their pieces of advice. But first, before I say that, before I turn to them, focus, I think, on what these guys have been saying. I think it's been brilliant. They've said, yes, it's the lowest possible price, but focus on the value of the home that you're going to buy. Be happy to pay a fair price. This is not the time when developers are making huge margins. It is the time of razor thin margins. So please don't expect, because input costs are not going down, your steel and cement and your land and everything is going up. Please don't expect real estate developers to sell below what is a rational price. And this is the time. This is a rational price. This is when the government is saying, guys, go ahead and buy. This is when CREDA is making the efforts. This is when right size, right price, all the geniuses and the great minds in the industry have come together and designed products. There cannot be a better window than buying right now. And when you do buy, please remember that you're going to enjoy the value of the home and sooner or later forget about the price of the home. So that has been the conversation with Mahesh and Udayan. Both of you have been absolutely fantastic. Before I let you go, I've already overshot by 4 minutes the time that I had taken from you. I didn't realize that it's 44 minutes instead of our 40, stipulated 40. But just before we leave, Mahesh and Udayan, what is your parting piece of advice to people who are sitting on the fence right now? Mahesh, we'll start with you.
Yeah, my advice to all my clients, if they're hearing me, this is the best time to buy, guys. Me as a prop buying Member, I assure you that you will get the best service from our end, and we'll be there with you till the position. So don't worry, whichever properties we'll suggest you, we always make sure that we can buy those properties. So that's the reason we suggest you to them. So rest assured with us that whatever we'll be showing, we make sure that we'll be there with you till the position time. So we assure you the best service.
Super, Mahesh. Uday, what's your advice?
So I feel we should lead with the example, and we it proves that we both have invested this year into the real estate after 8 years of break. The last home what we bought was 8 years back. So that says that, you know, if we are from real estate buying today in real estate, that means the time is here, the time is now. And the only thing that we miss out on is the cost of indecisiveness if you don't buy in time. So I think with a foray of 180 projects, right from Wagholi to Hinjawadi, you have lot many good options which are currently being offered at a very good price. That this is the right time when government is also helping you with some release in the taxation time. I don't know when the next time we will see that. So I think you should go hunt for the properties and just buy. Everything makes sense at the end of the day.
Super. Super Udayan, Super Mahesh, thank you so much. It's been great having you on the Golganga Pure Delight page. I'm sure everyone at the Golganga team is also super impressed with this conversation, because this is exactly what the team has always been saying. It's great to hear it when somebody else also concurs with our views. And I really hope that that 2021 pans out to be the dream year that all of us have been waiting for. All the best at prop buying. And thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank
we'll
you so
see you
much.
Soon.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
See you soon. Thank you.
See you. Bye bye.